We're going to talk about something pretty major going on with Ethereum today. Check this out. I have this CoinDesk article up. You're going to want to hear this. Be sure to watch till the end because we're going to go over a very major thing that's going on with Ethereum, staked Ethereum, and the merge right now, what it means for price now and in the future, what it means for the right plays and stuff like that. Seriously, go through this article with me. Watch this till the end. Hit the like button. Hit the sub button. Let's get into it. So staked Ether price discount widens to most since June ahead of Ethereum merge. Now this is what I'm talking about. Here's what that means. The discount in Lido's staked Ether is widening, perhaps due to holders switching to Ethereum ahead of the merge. Okay, that's what we're going to get into here. We're going to get into, why are staked Ethereum holders getting into Ethereum ahead of the merge? And even if you know the answer to that, believe me, there are more pieces to this than you probably realize. So let's go down more. First of all, here's the Dune analytics, right? So this is the last 90 days of staked ETH price. So the lowest staked ETH got back in June, we'll call it June, 15th. Looks like it got down to about 90% of the spot Ethereum price, right? So if Ethereum was $1,000, you could have got staked ETH for $900, 10% discount. Not bad, huh? But as you can see, it steadily came up over time. It came up here all the way to about 0.98, 98%. So if ETH is 1,000, staked ETH is 9,800. And it came back down in early mid-August, came back up, and now here we are. It's the lowest it's been since back here in June. And the merge is going to be happening 10 days or so, depending on when you're watching this. Lido's staked Ether token is trading at a 5% discount to Ether's price. Is that where we're at right now? Looks like that's about 95%. So you get if ETH was $1,000, which it's not, it's 1,500, but to keep it simple, if ETH was $1,000, you get it for 950. Stay with me on this. We have some real meat to get into here. You're gonna wanna hear this. Keep watching this video. The discount between the price of liquid staking protocol Lido's staked Ether, stETH, and the price of Ether widened to 4.5%. Right now it's at about 5%, the most since late June, according to data from Dune Analytics, which we looked at up there. The discount stems from investors' concerns, listen to this, of missing the opportunity to gain a potential Ethereum forked token, ETHPOW, Ethereum Proof of Work. That's what that stands for. Now, what does that mean, right? So we're talking about here getting free crypto on a different chain, on a forked Ethereum chain. Do you know what that means? Forked, like Ethereum chain's going along. It says, you know what? We're going to fork and create a separate chain. So now there's two chains going, right? That's kind of what's happening here. The merge is a little bit different than that, but I'm not getting into it. Just keep that simple. Going along, fork. Oh, okay, well, now I'm gonna go over here. So now you had coins here, but now you get coins here and here. So you get all of a sudden got free coins on this new chain, ETH proof of work, okay? So you have the ETH proof of stake coins, which are the same right now that you have, and then the proof of work will be new, just like Ethereum Classic is different. Keep watching the video, trust me on this. This is big, and this is something to really think about of what to do leading up to the merge, because most people, well, we're getting into what most people are doing, or many people are doing. I believe in being counter to the market in most of the time, and I'm gonna share that with you here at the end of this, but we got to go through it so it makes sense. So keep watching, hit that like button, hit that sub button if you haven't yet. So ETHPOW down to here. While most of Ethereum community favors switching to proof of stake, some miners are looking to preserve the proof of work mechanism. Why? I'll get into that. If they succeed, the chain will fork, splitting the POS and POW, proof of stake, proof of work, chains at the time of merge scheduled for about September 13th through 15th. I think it's about more like the 15th. We'll see, because it's not because of block counts and stuff like that, block transactions. It's not an exact moment, okay? It's not like you push a button. You do, but plays out as it plays out. So miners, why do miners want to do this? You probably know this already, but just to recap in case you don't, miners, keep watching this video, by the way. Proof of work, because miners, as you go to proof of stake, miners are out of business. They are out of business. And they're saying, I got all this gear, I want to keep mining. I want this gravy train to keep coming. I want to keep digging up Ethereum, mining this stuff. So if they have enough people on it, which they probably will, there will be a separate chain. Just kind of like there's Ethereum Classic, Ethereum POW, and Ethereum Proof of Stake, which Proof of Stake will be Ethereum. ETH POW will be ETH POW. Prisoner of War? What? Proof of Work. And then ETH Classic. So the latter would have ETH POW as a native token, and ETH holders stand to receive it for free. So traders holding derivatives tied to Ether and other Ether-related tokens like staked ETH won't receive it. Let me repeat this. If you are holding Ethereum, you will get the Ethereum Proof of Work stake coin, excuse me. And if you're holding staked ETH, which is a derivative, it's something that represents Ethereum, it's not real Ethereum, you won't get it. With that being said, there's more to this too, because if just because you have real Ethereum and it's sitting in your, say, Coinbase account or your KuCoin or your Binance, that also doesn't mean you're gonna get proof of work because it's not in your custody. If you have it in your MetaMask wallet, or whatever wallet, but I use MetaMask, so do most people. If you have it in there, you will get the proof of work. Keep watching this video. This is a big deal. This is something you absolutely need to know, especially as we're getting close to this video, the merge in like, what? What's the date today? The 7th. It's like 8 days away. So again, if you have a derivative like staked ETH, you won't get the proof of work. So people are getting out of, well, let's get into this. Let's go down a little further. That may have prompted staked ETH holders to sell their tokens in exchange for Ethereum, to position for a potential ETH POW airdrop or distribution. Each staked ETH token represents one staked ETH token and can be redeemed for Ethereum at some point after the merge. However, staked ETH holders can swap their tokens for ETH on a decentralized exchange like Curve. So when we look at that Dune Analytics back up there, right now you can exchange one staked ETH for 0.95 ETH, right? That's the way it works. It's staked ETH is trading at about 95% of Ethereum price. So if Ethereum's 1,000, staked ETH is 950. So you can go to Curve, DeFi, decentralized exchange, I guess you can call it that. You could probably do it on Uniswap. You could probably do it in a lot of, Uniswap or Curve would probably be the main place that I would do it. But you could swap your staked ETH. You don't need to, just because you have staked ETH, doesn't mean you have to hold it and there's nothing you can do with it. It's a derivative, so you can swap it for Ethereum. It has real value. It's worth 95% of Ethereum. So you can swap it and get ETH in your wallet and have it in there, the ETH, the real ETH in your wallet instead of the staked ETH, and be eligible for the proof of work token. So you get this free airdrop, okay? So that's what a lot of people are doing, but we're not done yet. Keep watching this video. I'm gonna share with you my thoughts on this, and believe me, you're gonna wanna hear it. Now, Aave, major DeFi lending platform, the biggest. Seriously, there aren't many DeFi projects I hold, but Curve is one of them. Aave is one of them. Uniswap. And then maybe a little Compound. Aave recently closed the door. Hear this. Big deal. Aave recently closed the door for traders looking to borrow Ethereum ahead of the merge on concerns that increased borrowing demand for Ether would expose the decentralized lending and borrowing platform to liquidity issues. Okay? Fascinating. So Aave said, that's it. A bunch of people are coming in here borrowing Ethereum. You know, so what you do there is you put up your crypto, maybe you put up staked ETH. I don't know what they allow you to put up as collateral to borrow Ethereum, right? And so what these people plan on doing, which is an interesting play, they're borrowing Ethereum temporarily just to get that, because if you have one Ethereum in your wallet, you're going to get one proof of work ETH POW token. You know what I mean? You're going to get one ETH POW token for every ETH token you have. What if I have less than one? Yes, whatever you have. If you have 0.1 Ethereum, you're going to get 0.1 ETH POW, okay? But people are saying, using their crypto, not spending any extra money, they're putting their probably USDC, something like that, maybe staked ETH. I don't know what you can use as collateral on Aave, what all you can use to borrow Ethereum, but that's what they're doing. They're borrowing Ethereum temporarily. They're saying, hey, I'm going to pretty much change my USDC into Ethereum for now, which is different than swap because you're not like getting rid of it, right? You're just borrowing it against it. So actually, if Ethereum goes down after the merge, you're in a better position. If I put up $1,000 of USDC to borrow to, you know, whatever that would be in Ethereum, like 0.7 ETH, well, I got to pay back 0.7 ETH. That's what I got to pay back. And if ETH goes from 1,500 to 1,000, well, instead of paying back $1,000, I only got to pay back 700 of USDC, right? But you're paying back in ETH, okay? So you're paying back in ETH. You'll have the ETH regardless. You will have the ETH. So if you went to Aave, this is getting long, but I just want to make sure you understand it. I'm almost done here. Keep watching, seriously. Still want to share with you what I think I'm going to do. So they're borrowing it so they can get that ETH POW for basically free, right? They're not buying any new Ethereum. They're just borrowing it temporarily, and then they're going to pay it back right after the merge with the Ethereum they already have. So there's like it's like a no-risk trade, basically. They're going to get free ETH POW. And Aave said a lot of people are going to do this, so we're closing the doors. This might get out of hand for us. We don't want to have liquidity issues. What is liquidity? It's the ability to fulfill on promises. It's really what it is, financially speaking. That decision spurred, check this out, that decision spurred, hit the like button if you haven't yet, if you're still here, and stick around because we're getting there. I'm going to share with you what I think I'm going to do. That decision, which is counter to most of the market, and that's usually a good thing to do in my opinion, and just statistically speaking, that decision spurred bankrupt Singapore-based crypto fund, Three Arrows Capital, to remove $33 million worth of staked Ether from Curve's staked ETH Ether pool. Interesting. They removed staked ETH from the ETH pool. Very interesting. Check this out. Listen to what Adam Cochran says. Aave pausing ETH markets causing Instadap to unwind massively in the staked ETH ETH pool, and Three Arrows Capital pulled their pool liquidity, making it worse. Did I just wake up back in July? Exactly. Is the next leg down really going to be the exact same trade unwinding? Exactly. Is the exact same thing that caused that last massive leg down in June? Is that literally exactly what's going to effing happen here now? Probably not. But it looks like it. But I just don't believe that things don't repeat necessarily exactly, but they do rhyme. And this is rhyming like Eminem on a hot flow. Seriously. Uncertainty drives demand. Listen to this. Lack of clarity on what happens after the merge could also be driving staked ETH holders to switch to ETH. Right? What happens, right? Uncertainty and risk. You still got how long you got to hold your staked ETH for to redeem it for ETH? Because no matter how much staked ETH is trading for right now, at the time of redemption, you can if you have one staked ETH, even though it's only worth 95% of one Ethereum right now, at the time of redemption, when you can exchange it for Ethereum, you will still get one full Ethereum for every staked ETH you have, regardless of its trading value. The May-June market pool showed that an imbalance, check this out, of staked ETH, ETH liquidity pool on Curve can complicate the exit for the staked ETH holders. Hear this. Look at this. At press time, so when they made this, I think this article is like less than a day old. The pool in Curve, the heart of DeFi. Curve is the heart of DeFi. The pool has reserves of whatever the F that number is supposed to be. It must be in something. Regardless, look at the percentages. About 23% of Ether and 77% of staked Ether. So that tells you people are a lot more interested in having Ether than staked Ether, basically 3-1. 3-1. So the main trade is to have ETH right now and get that ETH POW. And right now, if you look closely, it doesn't say that on here, but ETH POW is looking to be worth about 2.5% to at most 5% of Ethereum. Right? So if ETH at 1,000, POW is going to be worth $25 to $50. Probably closer to 25 is what it looks like. CoinDesk reached out to Lido for comment on the renewed widening of the staked ETH discount, and they have not received a response. Lido does not want to respond on this. It does not. If they have something good to say, they'd say it. But if they don't have something good to say, they're not saying anything. So they're nervous. Lido is also nervous about this. So what do I think? I think. Because when people get ETH POW, what's going to happen? They're going to dump it so fast, it's going to fall down like a, I don't know, a waterfall. Wish I could think of a better thing. I'm no Eminem. But what I think I'm going to do, I'm going to really watch as we get closer and closer to the merge. I'm going to really watch that staked ETH price. And if it goes down to like 93% or less, I am going to buy some staked ETH, stETH. That's not what most people are doing. Why? Because it's at a big discount. And I think people are putting way too much focus on getting the free ETH POW token and way too little emphasis on getting massively discounted Ethereum staked ETH. I mean, if the merge happens, what can you do? I mean, staked ETH, I can redeem it probably after the merge. If I get it at 92, 93%, I can probably redeem it for more like 97%, right? So I'm getting free Ethereum that way, an extra 4% of Ethereum. Or I can just hold it and or hold it till I can actually redeem it. And I just got like 8% free ETH, right? So I can get probably 3 to 8% on my money, which is roughly the same as ETH POW, but probably better, because ETH POW is probably going to be 2.5 to 5% of Ethereum, where staked ETH is going to be 3 to 8%. And watch out. If staked ETH goes down to like 90%, I'm going to buy so much of it. So keep your eye on staked ETH. It's at a big discount. And I think the discount's going to get bigger as we actually get closer to the merge. I'm talking within like a day or two of the merge. I think staked ETH is going to hit a bottom at that point, and your boy's going to swoop in. Hit the like, hit the follow. I'm going to be doing a TikTok live here in about 20 minutes. I usually do them about noon Pacific Standard Time, Monday through Friday. I have been on vacation off the grid for about a week, so I just got back. But watch out for all this. This is a big deal. And the merge, it probably will go good. But keep your fingers crossed. It needs to go good, okay? You're awesome. Thanks for watching. Hit that like, hit that sub. Check out the link in the description, too, if you want to check out some real good crypto resources. You're awesome.